Hello, you beauties. It's Toby and David of Curse with the Minecraft news from the past week, in which Notch creates a complicated yet attractive diagram in an attempt to explain his love of Skrillex.
First, at long last, there are stirrings in the world of LEGO as they confirm that the project we reported on a few weeks ago has been accepted, and concepts are now being worked through to bring together the best of the blocks of LEGO with the blocks of Minecraft. They will release more details soon. We can't wait.
Daniel Kaplan is pumped over seeing Junk Boy's art for the Xbox Live Arcade cover art, which presumably will dominate the Xbox version of Minecraft's page when it's finally released. We will be watching for more details very closely.
Notch reports that an estimated $200,000 in sales was held up by Mojang's 24-hour Sopa blackout on the 18th of January. However, the pull of Minecraft is so strong that many people who missed out during the blackout were back later, bumping the sales to higher than normal when service resumed.
A Twitter user has suggested slimes spawning naturally in the newly added jungle, which sort of fits with the slimy, wet nature of the jungle floor. Jeb seems to be on the same wavelength, so maybe we'll see some of that happening in the near future.
Notch has released a poll on his blog this week, asking us Minecraft players if we'd object to an implementation of some basic data collection, specifically what game types people are playing, if it's offline or online, and for how long. All data would be shared with the community, thus keeping Mojang's famed company transparency. If you feel strongly either way, you should head over to Notch's blog. Link is below.
There's some more news from the jungle this week in snapshot 12W04A. John has created his first mob, the Speedy Ocelot. They can be tamed with difficulty using raw fish. If you're still whilst holding a fish, they will approach you slowly and then can be tamed in the usual fashion. They can also be bred to make adorable kittens, and they come in three different colours: ginger, Siamese, and black. They will also stalk and kill chickens, so be careful around your poultry.
Two items have been added to the Creative Mode item selector: the Bottle of Enchanting, which can be smashed on the floor to release experience orbs, and Fireball. These can be crafted using coal, gunpowder, and blaze powder. When placed in the newly retextured dispenser and triggered, they fire, like a cannon setting their target on fire. Skeletons have received a new AI system, just as the zombies did last week. They display more intelligent behaviour now, noticeably hiding from the sunlight, among other things.
Finally, we've noticed water wells springing up in desert biomes. What sort of future update do you think they could be to do with? You made us laugh and amazed us with your creeper hat comments a couple of weeks ago, so leave a comment below and let us know what you think about these sandy wells. That's all from us this week. Please do hit the subscribe button and we will see you next time.